Hey everyone, that time it is I, and yes, Review-a-Palooza moving right along, and today we've got two final shorts from the Oshkosh Horror Film Festival. I told you there were a lot of them, and the two final ones on the block today, one of them is Skeleton, and the other one is Horizonte. Skeleton was written, directed, and edited by Eric Schneider. This is a gentleman, they brought us the Pumpkin Smashers on Lovecraft Lane, okay? A low-budget production, which you can actually catch online. Now, Skeleton gives us the story of a family that's surrounded by this kind of dark energy, specifically this little girl who is, you know, she doesn't have the best family life. She's not treated exactly well, but soon she has an ally, a dark ally, an ally that makes people pay who are mean to her. I enjoyed this, especially for it being such a low-budget film. Now, the audio isn't the most fantastic in this film, which a lot of lower-production films do end up suffering. But it didn't take away from my enjoyment of the story. I liked the idea of this little girl having an ally in the skeleton. And the way it was edited and the story was told was really well done for the low budget that they had. And the film does pick up and ramp up as it goes along in its creepiness, especially with the little girl. Girl's performance, who did very well for her part. In fact, everyone in here does decent for the role that they're given. It's a fun little story that definitely has a place in being told during Halloween. I could definitely see this in a compilation of some kind of horror shorts, something along the lines within an anthology like Trick or Treat or something. It could have a definite place in there because it was just enjoyable. A little short film that definitely brought the creepy and it surprises you a little bit at the end as well. Now, Horizonte is a sci-fi post-apocalyptic horror film involving vampires. We've got a mother who's escorting her daughter across country for a specific reason. And we see how they try to survive fighting the creatures that now have overtaken the land in this post-apocalyptic world. They're vampire-type creatures, though they're not quite the vampires that we're used to, which I really liked. I liked the original kind of spin. They gave them a little bit of interesting characteristics to them. Definitely great makeup effects as well. In fact, the production value overall for Horizonte is really good. Fantastic, really. This is from Spain, and it had Hollywood style production value to it. The story was interesting and kept you involved. You wanted to see exactly why the mother was taking her daughter across country and why exactly she was so keen on getting there. So I liked how that story played out, and also playing out what the mother did in order to survive and get what they needed to survive. So they make you feel for the mother, and you do attach yourself to that character. And the little girl in here does a great performance as well. For her role, she doesn't have a whole lot of speaking parts, but you definitely buy that this is a mother and daughter team. They've got some great chemistry together. And the ending was a surprise. I didn't quite see where that ending was going to go, which all of these indie films really, that's what I love about them, is you're never quite sure where the filmmaker's going to go with it. Unlike most of Schlollywood, not all, but most of Schlollywood films definitely keep you on your toes, and Horizonte definitely does that. So that about do it for us here with the final cut and our shorts. Stick around for Review-a-Palooza. We got a few more feature films from the Oshkosh Horror Film Festival, which I will bring to you. As always, comment down below, subscribe, and as always, keep your ticket stubs.